Hi, and welcome to Accounting Academy. I'm Fitz, and this is my dog, FIFO. We love to help people learn more about accounting, so join us on our adventures as we dive into accounting topics. On today's adventure, we are helping our friend Keith, who owns a pet grooming salon. He's taking on some debt and wants to help understand the accounting, so let's go. Hey Keith, how's business?
Hey guys, it's been a pretty rough year. I'm just joking, business is great.
Is that Pet TV?
Sure is, and the customers love it.
Anyways, how can we help?
Well, we were thinking of entering into a new debt agreement to help with the expansion efforts, and would love to have a refresher on the accounting.
Let me fetch you that information. Okay, sorry, FIFO. Let's jump into the topic with how the guidance was updated recently.
Sounds great. Let's start there.
So the important update from ASU 2015-03 simplifies the presentation of debt issuance costs.
What exactly are debt issuance costs?
Debt issuance costs are those costs associated with issuing loans and bonds, such as fees and commissions paid to investment banks, law firms, auditors, and regulators.
But that all changed?
Yeah. Under the old guidance, we would set up assets for the cost of issuing debt and amortize that over the life using the effective interest method. Now we would simply present them as a direct deduction to the debt liability amount. This is consistent with how we account for debt discounts and premiums.
You mentioned premiums and discounts. What exactly are those in relation to debt?
Sometimes debt is issued at a premium or a discount based on how the deal may be structured. So for example, if there's a 10% discount on par value of $100,000 of debt, that would be a $10,000 discount, meaning you would receive $90,000 of cash.
But I'd still owe $100,000 at the end of the life of that debt?
Yep, and a premium will work the exact opposite way. A 10% premium means you'd get $110,000 in cash, but only owe $100,000 at the end of the loan.
What would the journal entries look like?
Sure, we can take a look at that. Staying with those examples, your discount entries would be a debit to cash for $90,000, a debit to debt discount for $10,000, and a credit to debt for $100,000.
And what about a premium?
Yeah, it's similar, except for now you have a debit to cash for $110,000 and a credit to debt premium for $10,000 and debt for $100,000.
Okay, that's easy enough. But what happens with that premium over the life?
Great question. These discounts, premiums, and debt issuance costs all get amortized over the life of the debt using the effective interest method.
What exactly is the effective interest method?
The effective interest method is an accounting amortization technique that correlates interest expense with accounting book value of the bond or debt. Over time, as the debt balance increases, the amortization will also increase.
I think I'm going to need to see an example.
Okay, let's jump into Excel. Let's assume you got a $100,000 loan with an interest rate of 6% that matures in 5 years. Without being told our effective interest rate, we will need to use the GoalSeek function in Excel. But before we get there, we need to set up this Excel. In the column labeled A, we have set up our beginning balance.
Okay, and it starts at $90,000, which takes into account the $10,000 discount?
Correct. Each year after that is the ending balance from the previous year. In the column labeled B, we have cash interest, which is $100,000 times 6%. In column E, we have the principal payment of $100,000 for when we pay back the debt.
Okay, but it looks a bit funny right now.
Yeah, because we don't know our effective interest rate, we're going to have to set it up a bit funny at first. We are solving for column D by having it currently equal column A times the effective interest rate, which is currently empty. Also, we have modified column F to the current formula to help run GoalSeek.
Alright, what's next?
Now we use the GoalSeek function. This can be found at the top of Excel in the Data tab. In this version, over to the right, is the What If Analysis dropdown. In there, you'll find the GoalSeek. We want our ending balance to be zero, so for set cell, we put cell G12. And for to value, we put zero. In the last space, we put the effective interest at F2, which is the cell to be changed. Then it pops out your answer.
Wow, GoalSeek is an awesome Excel function.
Agreed, it's a big help.
Can we set up a premium as well?
Yeah, let's set up that same worksheet but for a premium. This time your beginning balance is $110,000. You need to change your ending balance formula to subtract the amortization. Make your effective interest zero for now, and let's run that same GoalSeek.
Wow, that makes it seem so easy.
Yep, and thanks to the new guidance, you would do the same thing with your debt issuance costs.
What would the journal entries look like?
Sure, that's a good step to go over. We already went over the discount entries earlier, so let's pull those up and compute our first year.
Yeah, that would be great.
At the end of the first year, your journal entries would be a debit for interest expense for the total of amortization of the discount and actual interest expense.
Okay, so $7,686?
Yep. Your credit would be $6,000 to cash for the interest paid and a credit to discount for the $1,686 of amortization.
Oh, I see how those entries work. Thanks. Okay, one last question. How would this look on my cash flow statement?
Good question. When debt issuance costs are paid for, they are a financing activity. However, interest expense is represented within your operating activities under net income. But because the amortization of debt issuance costs, discounts, or premiums are a non-cash activity, you need to subtract or add that activity back to operating income to represent only the interest paid in cash.
Thanks, Fitz. You made this really simple to understand. And if FIFO ever needs a new hairdo, just let me know.
Alright folks, thanks so much for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe. And if you can, donate to Patreon. Anything you can give helps to keep the lights on and ensures we can continue to create content. And of course, helps feed FIFO. If you want to contact us about anything you saw in this video, accounting advice, or ideas for future videos, contact us at patreon.com/accountingacademy.
This video is designed to be illustrative and does not represent an official position. We make no representations, warranties, or guarantees and assume no responsibility for the application of this material. Please seek advice from a competent professional if expert assistance is required.